Welcome to e-learning course on Applied Thermodynamics, Module Psychometry and Air Conditioning Systems, Session Psychometric Process. Myself Ramesh Biar, Assistant Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Jain Institute of Technology, Dhaundi. Psychometric Processes. There are 8 thermodynamic processes involved in air conditioning. To vary the psychometric properties of air according to requirements. Psychometric processes is a process of analyzing air conditioning processes. These can be represented on psychometric chart as shown in figure. The process 0 to 1, which is moving towards right side on the chart, is named as sensible heating process. The process moving from 0 to 2 onto the left side of the chart is called as sensible cooling process. The process which is moving in the vertical direction upward from 0 to 3 is humidification process. And the process from 0 to 4, which is moving downward in vertical direction, is called as dew humidification process. And the process which is moving from 0 to 5 is called as heating and humidification. And the process 0 to 6 moving in this direction is called as cooling and dehumidification. And the process 0 to 7 moving in this direction is called as cooling and humidification. And the last process 0 to 8 in this direction is called as heating and dehumidification. So these are the 8 thermodynamic processes which are involved in air conditioning. Now we see individual processes one by one. The first one is sensible heat process, where heating and cooling is carried out. First we see heating, then we will go for cooling. So for heating, we make use of a line diagram and psychometric chart here for better understanding. There is a heater or a heating surface or a heating coil or a hot surface. The air is made to flow over this hot surface. The initial condition of the air is T1 and omega 1. And the final condition of the air after passing over the hot surface is T2 and omega 2. And the process here, it is represented as 1 to 2 in horizontal direction or by a horizontal line on the psychometric chart. The temperature increases from T1 to T2, but the omega value remains constant. You can notice here omega 1 is equal to omega 2, and corresponding enthalpy values can be taken from the chart. So, heating of air without change in specific humidity is known as sensible heating process. Change in dBT occurs, change in enthalpy occurs, you can observe in your chart. So, temperature increases from T1 to T2, that is dry bulb temperature, and enthalpy also changes from H1 to H2, but omega remains constant, that is specific humidity is constant. Sensible heat during heating is given as Ma into H2 minus H1. Ma represents mass of air. H2 means final enthalpy and H1 is the initial enthalpy. So using this expression, we can find out the what heat during sensible heating. Also, we know that from the definition H is equal to Cp into T. Now we are going to substitute for H as Cpt. So, in the above equation, we get heating, that is sensible heating Q is equal to Ma into Cp into T2 minus T1. This expression can also be written as Ma into Cpa plus omega into Cpb into T2 minus T1. And this is based on the moist air. If it is a dry air, this is the equation. If it is a moist air, we are going to use this equation, where we are going to consider the moisture of the air. Next is sensible cooling. So here a cold surface or a cooling coil is used. So here is made to flow over the surface. So initial and final temperatures are taken as T1, T2, omega and omega 2 respectively of moisture, and the same is represented on the psychrometric chart. So cooling of air without change in specific humidity, that is omega, remains same, and change in dry bulb temperature and enthalpy takes place. Sensible heating equation is given as Ma into H1 minus H2. So it is written as H1 minus H2 instead of writing H2 minus H1, just to avoid negative sign here. And here Ma is the mass of dry air. Also we know that H is equal to CpT. Now substituting for H in the above equation, we get Q, that is sensible cooling of Q is given by Ma Cp into T1 minus T2. So this can also be written as Ma into Cpa plus omega into Cpv into T1 minus T2, and this is for moist air and this is for dry air. And this is about your sensible heat process, that is heating as well as cooling. Moving on to the next one, latent heat process, which is termed as humidification as well as dehumidification. So now we see humidification as well as dehumidification. So the psychrometric chart is used here, which represents humidification and dehumidification. The first diagram represents humidification, where the curve is going from point 1 to 2, or the line is going from 1 to 2. And dehumidification, the line is going from point 1 to 2 in the downward direction. So temperature is constant here, you can observe T1 is equal to T2, and here also T1 is T2. But enthalpy gets changed. Omega changes from omega 1 to omega 2, here omega 1 to omega, there is a change in enthalpy as well as specific humidity. So for humidification, addition of water vapor to the air without change in its dBT. So dry bulb temperature is constant, you can observe chart. So change in specific humidity and enthalpy occurs, and latent heat of addition is given by Ma into difference in enthalpy, that is H2 minus H1. So you can also write this one as Ma into HFG naught into omega 2 minus omega 1. It is based on the specific humidity of the moist air. And here T2 is equal to T1 because it is a humidification process, and HFG naught is the latent heat of evaporation at 0 degree Celsius. So the heat present in the air itself is used to evaporate the water vapor. That's why we are going to write the expression in the form of Ma HFG naught into omega 2 minus omega 1, where HFG naught is the latent heat of evaporation at 0 degree Celsius. Similarly, for dehumidification, so removal of water vapor from the moist air without change in dBT, so constant, it remains constant. So specific humidity changes, enthalpy gets changed. Equation is similar to latent heat of addition, but it becomes H1 minus H2, and it can also be written as Ma into HFG naught into omega 1 minus omega 2. So where T2 is equal to T1 and HFG naught is equal to latent heat of vaporization at 0 degree Celsius, right? So in humidification, we will increase the humidity content or the moisture content of the air. In dehumidification, we are going to reduce the moisture content of the air, and it is done based on the latent heat process. Next is adiabatic mixing of two moistures of air stream. So we are going to take two moistures of air stream entering at section 1 and section 2. Here the mass of air entering is equal to mass of air entering is equal to Ma1, and here mass of air entering is equal to Ma2, and the mixture coming out of this section 3 is equal to Ma3, and we are going to mix stream 1 and stream 2 at this point. So after that we will get the mixed stream of air, and the same is represented on the psychrometric chart with the different conditions with respect to different properties like dry bulb temperature, enthalpy and specific humidity. So when two or more air streams having different state conditions are mixed, the final state of the mixture will be having the new state condition, as we know already. For example, mixing of fresh and return air in air conditioning, cold storage, etc. figure shows the mixing process and its representation on the psychrometric chart. So some assumptions are made here. So what are those assumptions? The pipelines are adiabatically covered, so no heat losses will be there, and specific heat remains same for all the streams. So stream 1, stream 2 and stream 3. Then now we will take some important terms related to adiabatic mixing of two streams. So let MA1 and MA2 are mass of dry air at section 1 and section 2. This is section 1 and this is section 2, and this is mass of A1 and mass of A2. And H1, H2 are the enthalpies at section 1 and section 2, that is stream 1 and stream 2. Omega 1 and omega 2 are the specific humidities of air at section 1 and 2. So now, according to Gibbs theorem, we will write three expressions based on mass balance, energy balance and moisture balance. So mass balance is given as MA3 is equal to MA1 plus MA2, which is taken as equation 1. For energy balance, we will take MA3H3 is equal to MA1H1 plus MA2H2, which is taken as equation 2. And for moisture balance, it is MA3 omega 3, which is equal to MA1 omega 1 plus MA2 omega 2, which is equation 3. So these three equations are based on Gibbs theorem. Now we make use of these three equations and we'll move further. Substituting equation 1 in equation 2, that is substituting equation 1, that is mass balance equation, in energy balance equation. So now we are going to replace MA3 with MA1 plus MA2 in energy balance equation. So multiply MAH3 with MA1 and MA2, so you will get this. Now you take similar terms like MA1 and MA1H1, MA onto one side and MA2 onto the other side, you will get this expression. So now take MA1 as common here, you will get MA1H3 minus H1, and MA2 common here, you will get MA2H2 minus H3. So now we are going to write the expression in the form of ratios of mass, that is MA1 over MA2, which is equal to H2 minus H3 over H3 minus H4, and it is taken as equation 4. Further, we also know H is equal to CpT. So now replace H with CpT. So we can write equation 4 as MA1 over MA2 is equal to Cp into T2 minus CpT3 over CpT3 minus CpT1, and Cp is constant, it gets cancelled, and finally the expression becomes MA1 over MA2 is equal to T2 minus T3 over T3 minus T1, and it is taken as equation 5. Further, we are going to substitute equation 1 in equation 3 now. So mass equation, mass balance equation is substituted in moisture balance equation. So we will get this. MA3 is replaced with MA1 plus MA2. Multiply this with omega 3, you will get this. Then shift MA1 term onto left side and MA2 term onto right side, you will get this. Then you take out MA1 as common here, MA2 as common here, and you will get this. So the expression is MA1 into omega 3 minus MA1, which is equal to MA2 into omega 2 minus omega 3. Then write this in the form of mass ratio, MA1 over MA2, which is equal to omega 2 minus omega 3 over omega 3 minus omega 1, and it is named as equation 6. Now we can write comparison between equation 4, 5 and 6, that the ratios are same, it is MA1 over MA2. So finally what we can write here, MA1 over MA2 is equal to S2 minus S3 over S3 minus H1, which is equal to T2 minus T3 over T3 minus T1, which is equal to omega 2 minus omega 3 over omega 1. And this is a comparison between different streams based on enthalpy, temperature and moisture for a adiabatic mixing of two streams. Next we see evaporative cooling process. Since energy is required to evaporate water, a cooling process based on evaporation called evaporative cooling can be used to reduce the dry bulb temperature of air without need for a traditional air conditioning system. However, evaporative cooling causes an increase in the relative humidity of an air stream, so that it is most effective when the air to be cooled is warm and has a low relative humidity. So we make use of a figure here, schematic diagram, as well as representation of process on psychometric chart. The evaporative cooling process is shown schematically in the figure and the process diagram as it would appear on psychometric chart. warm dry air enters the evaporative cooler, where it passes through a spray of liquid water. Energy extracted from the air to evaporate water causes the dry bulb temperature to reduce. That's why the line is moving towards left. Where the dry bulb temperature of the air to decrease, as shown in the process diagram. The humidity ratio of the air increases as the water evaporates and mixes with the stream. So the line moves in the upward direction. The evaporative cooling section is considered to be adiabatic. The heat transfer to the surrounding is usually negligible. In the analysis of evaporative cooling process, the conservation of mass equation for steady flow is first applied to the dry air. So that is, conservation of mass is means it is mass of A1 is equal to mass of A2 is equal to MA, and then to the water, that is MA1 omega 1 plus MW is equal to MA2 omega 2, or else you can write this as MW is equal to MA into omega 2 minus omega 1. So based on this, we are going to identify what is the amount of mass supplied to the evaporative cooling, or else what is the amount of water required to reduce the temperature as well as to humidify the dry air, based on the expression MW is equal to MA into omega 2 minus omega 1. And this is all about your evaporative cooling. Next, we will move on to cooling tower. A cooling tower is a device which uses the principle of evaporative cooling to cool warm water. Warm water is cooled by evaporation, and in the process, the humidity ratio of air increases. Since cooling is produced by evaporation, it is theoretically possible to obtain cooled water at the wet bulb temperature of the air. In thermal power plant, a large quantities of cooling water is necessary to operate the condensers. Hence, cooling towers are extensively used to provide large quantity of cold water. There are two types of cooling towers in common use. They are natural draft cooling towers and forced draft cooling towers. A schematic of cooling tower is shown in figure. The warm water to be cooled enters at point 3, this is that, and it is sprayed from the top of the tower. The falling water passes through a series of baffles, which breaks the stream into fine droplets. Atmospheric air is drawn, at 1 by the fans, which is located at the top of the cooling tower. The fine sprays of water provides large surface area for energy transfer and evaporation. The air gets humidified and leaves the tower at section 2. The outgoing air has higher humidity ratio than the incoming air. The cool water leaves the tower at 4. Since some water evaporates to increase the humidity of air, a makeup water is usually added in the cooling tower. The performance of cooling tower can be obtained by applying mass and energy balances to the cooling tower. Let MA1 is equal to MA1 and MA2 is equal to mass flow rate of dry air into and out of the cooling tower. Omega 1 and omega 2 are humidity ratios of air at inlet and outlet of the cooling tower. MW3 is equal to mass flow rate of warm water into the cooling tower. MW4 is the mass flow rate of warm water out of the cooling tower. Now, mass balance for air is MA1 is equal to MA2 is equal to MA. Mass balance for water is MA1 omega 1 plus MW3, which is equal to MA2 omega 2 plus MW4, or else you can write it as MW3 minus MW4, which is equal to MA into omega 2 minus omega 1, which is equation 1. Energy balance can be written as MA1 H1 plus MW3 HW3, which is equal to MA2 H2 plus MW4 HW4. Rearranging, we will get MA H2 minus H1, which is equal to MW3 HW3 minus MW4 HW4, which is equation 2. The equation 1 and 2 can be simultaneously solved to obtain the required air flow rate and makeup water, which is MW3 minus MW4. Here, moving on to previous slide. So, the energy balance means you have to make whatever the energy entering the cooling tower and what is the energy leaving the cooling tower. Similarly, mass balance means what is the total masses entering the cooling tower and leaving the cooling tower. So, based on that, we have to make the energy balance, mass balance and water balance. Okay. So, we end here and this is the end of session. Thank you so much. Please do subscribe to my channel, BR Mech Academy.